Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome to ASD App Store Domination. And today we are going to talk about warnings and errors and what's the difference between them. So let's get to work. Okay. Most of you, when you just open up an Xcode project, don't really get any warnings or errors. But if you just start typing in, or maybe it's an old project, then probably errors or warnings will come. And I want to clarify in this video what is the difference between warnings and errors. So the major difference between errors and warnings is that with warnings, your code will compile and will build and you have a valid app, it runs. But if you have errors in your code, then it will not compile, it will not run, it will simply crash. Of course, you have hidden crashes, but that is not what I'm talking about. Today we are going to talk about what the Xcode interface really shows you. And let me just go into some, a simple example. So let's go into view controller and let's create here a constant. And let's hit command B to build it. And as you can see, we have a reference to member purple cannot be resolved without a contextual type. And this is an error. So we need to add here UI color dot purple. Okay, and this should fix it. But now we are having a warning, and that is with this yellow triangle, not the red circle. We have a yellow triangle, and it says initialization of immutable value background color was never used. Well, it basically says that we have created constant and we are never using it. So let us just use it here and silence that warning. Okay, if we didn't do that, we can also go back and use the suggestion, and that is if you click on here and let's fix it, we just simply replace it with an underscore. And as you can see, if we tried to build, let's just go back here, and we still have this error. Let's build and run. Okay, we need to select a target here, simulator, iPhone 10. And this way our project will build and it will run eventually. Let's just go ahead and here we have our red. But if we have an error in it, let's build and run again. Build has failed, so we cannot run our project. So let's go back here. And I really like this background color, so I will just replace this red. So let's build and run one last time to see it in action. And here we have our purple background. Good stuff. And now you know what is the difference between warnings and errors. And of course, if you just let me just go back and have that warning here. Here we have it, let's build it with command B. And it says here that we have one warning and it says Swift compiler warning. And you have all of these warnings. And when you open an older project, you have these warnings. Most of in these, first starters, they think, oh, this is a very huge problem. Well, it is, you should always take care of your warnings. But it's not a big deal. And of course, don't come writing to me, oh, I have a lot of errors. Well, these are not errors. Your project will compile. But these are warnings. And sometimes these warnings come in third-party libraries with CocoaPods. And we need to let the the creators of those CocoaPods deal with those warnings. Don't go inside a CocoaPod and fix those warnings. You just have to wait and then update your CocoaPods. Well, that is a the story for a whole another video, and we will get into CocoaPods real soon. So if you did like this video, go ahead and make sure you know now that what is the difference between the warning and an error. I'm sure by now you do know, because I have hit the nail so hard in the head in this video. So if you like this video, go ahead and check out my other product here, the Tribe. And if you are an indie, go ahead and send us a message. Just simply click on contact us and ask for a huge discount. Of course, you need to be an indie developer or an indie studio. Go ahead and ask for a discount for the Tribe. And this is the Tribe. And I think I will finish this video off with this message. Go ahead and take a look at the Tribe, and I will see you tomorrow in the next one. Good stuff. Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below, and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work.